transportation designer, they will play a vital role in making such decisions. You know? So these are called aggregators. You know? Are you getting it? Even Airbnb, for example, you've heard of Airbnb. They don't own any hotels or any dormitories or any living spaces. They just aggregate it. They put it all together. Facebook, it all brings in your picture. It uses your information to give it back to you and to disseminate the information to everyone else. So they are like aggregators. Yeah? Are you getting it? And they all need designers. Then there is a company called Amazon. They are called the marketplace brand. So Amazon brings in all the sellers of products together on one platform to service diverse range of customers. They don't own any seller or products. They just put it together. They use their brand and their platform and their logistics to provide services to you, to the customer. Now, just imagine what new changes will be needed to bring in change in the human behavior for their buying decisions. Now, here we need the help of designers. System designers, experienced designers, service designers will play a vital role in improving the organization, Amazon. Yeah? All these companies which I'm talking about are the future employers of design services and for design. Yeah? Publication design. For example, a company called Penguin, they will bring authors to enable publishing their books. So what new changes will be needed to bring in a change in the human behavior for reading and for buying books and for having an immersive experience in reading books? So you will need a graphic designer, a publication designer. They'll play a vital role in this process. You know? So you also need a designer there for change in human behavior. New startups will need new ideas to start new businesses. So the ideas which can bring in a change in the human behavior, and ideas are the new currency of a designer, any designer. Yeah? Skills, something we can learn and you can forget and you can relearn. Yeah? But ideas is your new currency. That is something which no one can take away from you, and they will always evolve. Your ability to generate new ideas will keep on evolving depending on how you learn, how do you evolve yourself as a human being, as a design learner. So based on how design works with other disciplines, let's do some crystal ball gazing and peep into the design opportunities for the future. Yeah, because design works with science, it works with engineering, it works with art, it works with the digital world. So let's look at some of the future opportunities of designers. And very interesting. Very few. Because the future designers will confront new technologies. There'll be new technologies. There'll be also very complex social and personal communication problems. There'll be also problems of mobility. There'll be also problems of environmental and life issues, health issues. How the future designer will confront all this? So there are some few possibilities I'll just share with you. There can be a designer called augmented reality designer in the future. What he will do? He will design a layered, intuitive and immersive experience to a wide spectrum of industries like education, entertainment and healthcare. I don't know whether you guys watch some of the Netflix series, but the whole lot of augmented reality has been brought in into curing patients in their diagnosis, in the healthcare. Yeah, so you can operate a person who is in US from Germany, sitting on in Germany itself. You can see the person completely, and using augmented reality, you can actually instruct a robot to do the entire operation by voice control. That is the augmented reality designer. And that is the future possibility of a design profession. Avatar program and designer. A lot of rich clients, a lot of clients will require their digital representation in virtual scenarios, especially for virtual reality games, video games, and movies. So you'll see a lot of doppelgangers in the movies, you know, and the person is not there, but you feel as if the person is there, and you can put the person into various situation, even the daredevil situations, you know, and you think this is the real guy working, but actually is his avatar who's working. And that happens in films nowadays, in movies. It already started, you know, and that is where there's a future possibility of the design profession. Yeah. I hope and I wish the companies will, every company will have a chief design or a creative officer. The way you have a CFO, you know, a chief financial officer, or you have a CTO, chief technology officer. I wish that their companies, all companies will have a chief design or a chief creative officer, CDO or CCO. And that person will be present in every company, overseeing the design of every touch point of the business, which can maximize efficiency and purpose of the business. Yeah. I have met one chief designer long time back when I was a student in IDC. He was the chief design officer of a company called Philips. I still remember his name, Robert Blake. He was an interesting person. He was responsible for everything which is to be communicated in terms of design across all the products, you know. The entire brand communication, specification of all the products of Philips, whether it's healthcare, is medical product, is appliances, is lighting, everything. He was a big guy. Yeah. So again, I come back to where I started, where I said design is basic to all human activities. But as we grow, we need to relearn, unlearn, and learn. Yeah. So what we need to relearn, what we need to unlearn, what new we need to learn is something which I'm going to tell you about. What we need to relearn? Childlike intense curiosity about everything. I'm sure you remember your childhood, which you used to ask questions, probing questions, you know. And sometimes the questions were even unpleasant, which your parents were not prepared to answer, or they were not in a position to answer. So the ability to ask probing questions is something which you relearn, which we forget during our horrible, horrendous school experience. Yeah? Ability to meet extreme strangers and communicate with them without any bias of caste, color, or creed. That is the childlike quality which we have to relearn, which we forget. We don't meet strangers. We are afraid of strangers. We think that, okay, this guy is he speaks a different language. Why? How should I communicate? He's of different color. He's of different religion, different creed, different country, different geography. How will I learn from him or her? So that ability is where to relearn. Yeah. We also have to relearn the fearlessness of a child. A child is, he explores only because he doesn't have any fear. And in some time he also harms herself or himself. But that fearless of a child is something which we have to relearn, all of us. Yeah? What we need to unlearn, something which we have acquired over the years of our schooling and our parenting, first is the fear of structures and rules. We learn in such a structured and such a rule-intensive environment in schools that we start fearing them, you know. So fear of structures and rules, we are in my earlier institutions, they were afraid of working with clay. But there was one student who developed allergy because she was working with clay. There were a lot of students who never eaten with their hands. They've always eaten with fork and spoon. It was amazing. It was also very shocking. So use your hands. I know of a friend from Japan. He's a graphic designer and an architect and a product designer. Some person called Mitsui Omura. He was telling me in Japan, they think they always protect their hand using special gloves because they think that the hand is almost like a computer. Your hand is like a computer. It has such an ability to mold things, to observe things, to touch and feel. I mean, each of you have that great sense, but you have, maybe you have stopped exploring it. it would be a good idea that you get up in the morning, go to your kitchen, close your eyes, open the various canisters and jars, and put your finger inside and see what is happening, you know. Touch it, figure out, and find out with your eyes closed, what is it which I'm touching, you know. Yeah, what is it, which texture is this, what material it could be, you know, and smell it maybe, and figure out. I do this kind of test with my students. When I take a class on sensorial development, how do you develop your senses other than visual? All of us are overusing our visual sense, overusing it. It's not required. Learn to connect up with your other senses as well. The sense of taste, sense of smell, sense of touch, and, you know, sense of your basic structure, the body, yeah, which is a basic sense, yeah, sense of hearing. You need to develop your senses, because if you want to be a good designer, you have to develop all of your senses, you know, because you never know at what stage of technology you'll be working. Earlier, you could not have thought that, you know, I'll be able to transport images from one place to another. But it is happening now, right? It's quite possible that in the future, you'll be able to digitally send smells using special technology of pheromones and all that. You know? So your smell, which are like pheromones, will convert into ability to use and develop your senses. This is what I was telling, not just visual, but all other senses. So eat different kinds of food, smell different kind of smells, you know, go and touch things. Yeah. Ability to develop your own designer's toolbox. What is a designer's toolbox? Sketching skills, using your hand, sketch. 3D modeling. You work on digital areas and work on 3D modeling. Make things, you know. Start making things by your own hands. Walk daily. Most of the philosophical ideas will come when you walk. Your daily walk should be your designer's toolbox. Walk every day. Walk alone. Walk anywhere. Ability to organize things. Ability to push boundaries and look beyond design in other fields. And last, desire to go from unknown to unknown, to known to unknown. Always get yourself into a situation where you are going from known to unknown. That is where design happens. Because the moment I tell you to design a glass, you will start asking, okay, what material? You ask, okay, the glass is for what? Okay, how big? Who's the user? Now, all that is something which you don't know, right? So you thought you knew about glass, and suddenly someone tells you to redesign it. Now you don't know. So that is an important learning of a desire to go from known to unknown, or from information to exformation. The new word called exformation. Information is something which you have, you know it. Exformation is something which is not known to you. And that is where creativity or the design lies. That is where your opportunity to be a designer lies. Yeah? Thank you for your precious time and your patience. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. So students, now we'll have the question answer round. If you have any question that you want to ask, sir, you can absolutely go ahead and ask. Could be anything, not necessarily what sir explained you right now about design and its opportunity and how you need to perceive design as, and as a student, how you need to, you know, start thinking on design. But even if you have any other question, I mean any other question, and no question is a wrong question. So please go ahead, unmute yourself and ask your question if you have.
Can I stop sharing my presentation?
Sure, sir.
Okay. Unless the student wants to refer to my presentation, then I can keep it on. So.
Anything that you want to ask students? Let's this be a very interactive session. This is not a session where we have to come and give you a lecture and tell you. We want to understand you because you are the young minds, you are the young designers, you have to pursue a career in this and you also like it. So if you want to really understand if there's something that is missing out or if there's something that you really want to know about, please go ahead, ask sir questions. Anybody, if you, I see there are 38 participants. So any, I don't think that there's not single one student who wants to ask a question.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Because you see, I think what I understood of this presentation that sir gave, there was one very important statement that he made was, as designers, you are very powerful. As designers, you have some power to create something, to go in areas where people might have never gone into, to create something which was never there. You see, and then you have to go from there. People, you design things for something which is never there, for unknowns, for maybe an issue I had, and you have to, as a designer, understand me, my perception, my mind, my need, and then develop something. So as designers, I think it's very important for you to understand this concept of empathy and also understand that you have to enter in fields and areas which have not been known. Yeah. And you're very young designers, you're beginning to do it. So please do not restrict yourself. That's the, I think, first and most important point. The moment you restrict yourself, the moment you put yourself into boundaries, into some areas, this is where you are not letting yourself evolve. Yeah. So students, can I have some question, anything? I can see so many people, and I think those of you who had switched on their cameras have also switched it off. So please do not. Yeah, go ahead, Jyoti.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jyoti, you had to ask something.
Yes, I'm actually Sanjana. I'm not able to rename it, but okay. Anyway, so my question was that I read about Mr. Sanjay that you have been an engineer as well. So you have done your engineering as well. Do you think it has helped you in any way? Because
yes.
I have read like a lot of designers have been engineers before and then they came into designing. So there is this moment of dilemma whether, you know, you should go into engineering right now or designing.
So what is the question?
Has it helped you? And do you think you should have probably taken design from the very beginning?
No. Okay. Design is something which is, as I told you, is basic human instinct, you know. So I was, okay. Can I tell you about my background? I was, my father was a painter. He used to paint beautifully. So I was his errand boy. I used to mix paints for him. I used to wash his canvas, and he introduced me to color and composition, you know. Yeah, that was the beginning of my sort of a design education from childhood. But later on, I wanted to join Air Force, you know, as a jet fighter pilot. You know? So I appeared for National Defense Academy. I got in, but I was medically rejected because I had knock knees problem. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so at that time I was very young. I was just 16 years old. Yeah, so I had a massive desire to get out of my place and go somewhere else. You know? So I joined, I appeared for IIT exam and I got through it. And I had not decided what I'm going to do. My father wanted me to become an IFS officer. So you can see how the thing changes. It's like a clock, you know.
Right.
He wanted me to go to Indian Foreign Service, which I completely refused. So I went to IIT, and IIT was an interesting learning experience. But when I was in IIT, I used to, almost in third year, I developed a dislike for what was happening as a part of the learning process. It's not that I hated engineering. How the engineering was taught, I was not happy with it. Because I used to visit IDC, Industrial Design Center, where I used to see people creating things, you know. So, and I would not, was not able to see the desire. The engineers were creating things. They were just reading and solving problems. You know, there was a lot of theoretical, analytical learning. So that was the move. I shift, kept on going to IDC more often than my classes in engineering. And then I was slowly enchanted by the very act of this creative process. And then I joined design. But it doesn't take away any credit in terms of what I have learned in engineering as a way to think and think in terms of functionality and how things work. So IIT provides you a knowledge and upbringing to solve problems, which are theoretical, but also it gives you an analytical power, which is essential for design learning as well. Yeah.
So I think, got it, sir. Thank you.
I think sir moved his boundary of IIT and he kept going to the IDC center more often. So yeah. He thought to explore more. So you see how, unintentionally, but he was able to direct
understand, his life. Understand your desire. I mean, yes. Listen to yourself, you know. Don't go by what parents say or what your friends say or what your relatives say. Listen to yourself and explore yourself, you know. Even if it is an unpleasant situation for society, or for your parent, doesn't matter. Follow your passion. Whatever you are passionate about, just do that. It could be anything. It could be even mopping a floor. It's not important what you can be a good floor mopper, one of the most creative floor mopper also. It's just that be with the flow. Listen to your heart and go with your heart. That is important. And constantly keep on asking questions. Ask questions. Why I'm doing this? Why? What is in it for me? Am I enjoying it? Am I learning enough? If not, move somewhere else. It doesn't matter.
Absolutely. Okay, got it. Thank you.
Yeah, because even as a designer, even if you become a product designer, let's say, assume, you might like to do something else later on. A lot of my students are not designing products. Some of them are scuba divers. Some of them are like social innovators, you know. They don't all the time design. They do something else, whatever their heart goes to. So design education is about being able to decide for yourself.
Okay, got it.
Make your own decisions, informed decisions. Yeah, thank you.
Yes.
So I think we had Ravi raising his hand. He has some question.
Yeah, Ravi. Where is Ravi? Can I see him?
Ravi Patil.
Ravi Patil, can I see you?
Good evening, sir.
Please show up. Ravi Patil.
Ravi Patil.
Okay. Ravi, can you show up yourself?
Yeah.
Excellent. So it's pronounced as Ravi? Ravi.
Ravi.
Yeah. Ravi. Yeah. All right. Sorry, Ravi. So go ahead. Please ask your question.
Yeah. So I had a question. Like sometimes we have design blockages, like you can't think about anything or you can't have any idea. So at that time, like what activities can we do? Like you even can't get inspiration from our daily things. So is there any way like we can get more and more ideas? It's not about ideas. It's about like keeping your mind up, thinking for something regularly.
Go to nature.
Okay, sir.
Just go to nature. Go for a walk.
Okay.
Yeah. Look at nature. Look at the tree. Look at the leaves. Look at the birds. Just go to nature. You will get ideas. I can assure you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, just make it a habit. Make it a habit. Go for a walk. Talk to yourself. Look at things and don't look up. Look down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Look down. What is happening? You know, we normally see only like we just go and see this much. We look down.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, look down what is happening, you know, and just watch nature. Nature is the largest source of information and but a very rich treasure trove. Just look at nature, how it works. Yeah?
I think absolutely, sir, you're very correct. I mean, when you see around and simple things like clouds, when you see around, you try to imagine some faces, some creatures or something, you know, when you see simple clouds. I'm sure when you're sitting and when you're observing things, you'll see so many and so much.
And Ravi, also talk to a child.
Okay.
Yeah, sir. I think that's the best way. I personally think that's the best way because they imagine.
Just talk to a child and if possible, take the child also for a walk.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. it's really nice.
You'll have a fun time also. You'll also get to observe and you'll also have a fun time, I'm sure. Because
you'll be also responding to his questions, no? His or her questions. Yeah? So just do that. It's very interesting. I have learned so much. I have learned my language. I used to stammer a lot. I also was not very conversant with English as a language because my school was a Hindi medium school. So I used to go out for a walk and talk to buffaloes and cows. English, because they don't understand it. So it's okay. So I just got rid of my stammering and also got rid of my fear of talking in a different language, which is not my own, which is not my mother tongue. And that's why I'm able to speak fluently. Yeah. Wow, just talk to cows and buffaloes. They don't really say, hey, it's not right. Your pronunciations are wrong. Just talk to cows and buffaloes. You know, that is the only way to learn a language.
Awesome. Any more questions that I have? And I think now by understanding the kind of conversation we have, any question. So I think Diya, you raised your hand. Please go ahead, ask a question.
Always don't, you know, ask. Don't be afraid of asking questions because you are actually doing a service to a lot of other people who are not asking questions. Yeah. So it's a great service which you are doing by asking questions. The questions are never foolish. There are no questions which are foolish, you know. So please ask anything under the sun and beyond it.
Absolutely.
I don't know. I will tell you.
So, sir, you were talking about unlearning. What is something we could do on a daily basis which could help us, you know, unlearn what all things you talked about?
Yeah.
Can't happen so fast and overnight.
See, everything, Diya, everything is about creating small habits, you know, small habits, which is like a drop in the ocean, but they have a long-term value. Yeah? So, for example, you're saying unlearn. Ask questions. Do you ask questions? How many times you ask questions in a day? Can you write down every day how many questions you have asked to yourself or to your parents or to your teacher? Write down the number of questions you ask. Maintain a diary of asking questions every day. Yeah, that would be an interesting way to start, you know. Yeah, that is one. Second thing is, as I was telling you in the morning, explore your kitchen to develop your senses, you know. Kitchen is a massive lab to explore your other senses, you know. Go blind, check out, open jar and smell. Keep on smelling things and figuring out isme kya hai, isme kya ho sakta hai. And then figure out, you know, whether you're right or wrong. It will develop your sense of smell, sense of taste, sense of, you know, connecting up your, because it is by research, it shows that when you smell, a lot of your neurons gets activated, you know, which also helps you think. So it's about activation. The moment you are activate yourself through any other sense, any sensorial experience, it'll help you think better. It'll help you learn faster and also unlearn. What is it which in my slide, what I've told you about unlearning? Do you remember it?
Yeah. So unlearning things like the fear of missing out or
yes,
having fear to ask.
I remember all of my students use this word called FOMO. FOMO.
Yes.
Fear of missing out. I wonder what is, I never heard this term when I was young. I never heard this term. So this is something which is a new phenomena, fear of missing out. So what is the fear of missing out? Analyze it. You know, maybe you're missing out on something, but you're gaining something else. You know, figure out what is you're gaining by missing out on something. For example, someone tells you, have you seen this series? So I said, okay, I've not seen it, but I've done something else. You know, did you see this thing on Facebook? You say, no, I've just talked to a child, or I'm just playing with a child, or I was just, sleeping.
Maybe reading a book.
Figure out what you want to do. I mean, if you, the moment you start comparing yourself with someone else, you will always be in this constant fear of missing out. You know? Listen to your own voice. Do what you love doing. There is a very interesting book called Flow. It's a book called Flow. Read it. It's a complex book, but it's an interesting book. How do you get this flow? Like when you do something and after some time you realize you're really enjoying it and you don't really care about what other people are doing, you know. Get into that process in whatever you do. So if you're eating food, eat food. Don't watch mobile. Eat food. Concentrate on eating food. Enjoy that, you know. Someone must have really worked hard to make food for you, no? So honor that. Just love eating food. Enjoy the smell, the colors, the texture, how it is, how you're feeling, you know, about it. And just be with it. Get in the flow of whatever you do. Yeah. So when you go for a walk for a daily walk, don't take your mobile. Don't take it with you. Cut it off. Just get into the flow of walking. Just enjoy the pleasure in your muscles, the smell of the, you know, the trees and leaves and flowers and, you know, and just the way you're walking. Enjoy that. And sometimes enjoy walking bare feet as well. You'll feel the pleasure of earth, you know, how it feels beneath your feet, you know. That would be interesting. Yeah?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
And stop worrying about grades.
The most important thing.
No one looks at grades, you know. Yeah. They look at you.
Yeah.
They look at how have you evolved. No one has time to be curious about your grades, you know. Yeah? So whenever you learn, stop bothering about your grades. I never bothered. So
I think your life is more I think beyond numbers. You can't just stick to numbers. Yes, I think we had this another student also raising the hand. I think Pradhanesh, you were raising your hand.
Yeah. Good evening. My name is Prerna actually.
Okay.
I wanted to ask, like, does when a designer thinks, and what is the difference between a designer thinking and a group collectively thinking? So does ideas flourish? Does brainstorming help? And if a designer on a personal level, what does he experience? Like, I love brainstorming, group discussions. So, but when you think on a personal level, how do you benefit from it?
I think it's a combination of both. The ideas will come from you, but the ideas will also come from the group thinking, you know, because there are a lot of minds working together. Yeah. And it's possible that the people have better ideas. You know? How do you know that they have better ideas? And whenever you work, you will always work as a design team. You'll always work as in a collaborative team, you know, because you're working for an organization, you're working for a startup, you're working for a studio. You will always work in group, you know. So the ideas can be yours, but there can be some better ideas, you know, which can help in cross-pollination. There's something called cross-pollination, you know. So it's both are important, your own thinking, and also your collaborative thinking with the team. Both are essential. Yeah? Does it answer your question?
Yes.
And you had something also about design thinking. You're talking about design thinking? You're saying design thinking?
No.
Yeah. Because design thinking is a buzzword, you know? So you better forget it.
Buzzword as in?
It's a buzzword. It's just a marketing design for non-designers. So design thinking is a buzzword which is used to tell non-designers how designers think.
Which actually is a myth.
Which is basically talking and discussing ideas.
No, design thinking is not how designers work.
Can you explain?
Yeah, I'll explain to you. Maybe the class is too small to explain that. But design thinking is a buzzword which is about telling non-designers how designers think. Because you can't communicate with the non-designers how designers think, no? So they use a buzzword called design thinking. But designers don't work with design thinking, which you will realize only when you start working as designers. Yeah, it's a little premature for you to appreciate it and understand it, you know. But design thinking is a buzzword, so don't take it too seriously. Yeah.
I think in a layman's term, sir, I think sir means to say that you don't really have to have a particular thinking type as a designer.
Yeah.
You are over and beyond that.
It's like a package. It's like a package tour. See, when you travel to an unknown place, there are two ways of traveling it. One is for a tourist who is not from India. Like for example, you are traveling in India. So there is a package tour for a non-Indian.
Yes.
A tourist who is coming from outside. So it's a package tour, it's a safe tour to see all the points or the touch points or have a experience, you know, for a tourist who is coming from outside country. But if you like to go yourself, you may not like to go for a package tour, no? You like to explore it as it flies, as it goes, you know. On the fly, you explore it. That is a much better exploration, is far more enjoyable for you. Because you know India, you know how to find your way through, you know. That is the difference between design thinking for designers and design thinking for non-designers.
So for non-designers, your world is your thinking. Anything and everything you can do.
Because you never know, design thinking doesn't happen in packages, you know. It's not a four-step process. It doesn't happen like that.
Yeah.
So your solutions need not come after a research. Solution might even come before the research, you know. It's possible. Are you getting it? You have a problem. You can come up with a solution immediately. And then you can do research, whether you're thinking right or wrong. But a design thinking module will tell you, first research, then analyze, and then design. That is not the process designers, intuitive designers designing process happens like that. It doesn't happen like that. Yeah? Okay.
Anybody else with any other question? Or there's a small exercise that I'd like to do with you all. Maybe if some of you could share, what did you really like in the session today? What was one thing that you really stuck to, and what was one thing that you really felt that, okay, this is something that I really learned, or this was a new perspective to me? Anybody?
Yeah, and I think you should have some incentive for them.
Absolutely, I'll definitely plan some incentive for these students. So yeah. Anything that really made you, okay, this was new to me. Maybe I think somebody was asking about how do you unlearn things. I mean, you've always heard professors, teachers telling you learn, understand, you know. But here is the professor telling you about unlearning. So I think this is a new term. So what was one thing that really caught your attention? And what was one thing that you really felt was, you know, new to me? Anybody?
Did you like the presentation?
I think that's the first question.
Yes, sir.
Or did you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, someone is talking. Zainab is talking. Zainab? Hello? Or Neha? Neha Murai? Are you there?
Yes, sir. I was saying that I really enjoyed the session. It was really informative.
What did you learn? What is one thing which comes to your mind, which you learned, stuck to you?
So that I can still freely change without, if I have a doubt I still have a doubt that I don't want to pursue the stream anymore, so I can still change it. It gave me a certain kind of hope.
Yeah, can I see you? Because I can see some funny face. I'm sure you're not that funny.
Yes.
Oh, you are Neha Murai. You are a boy or a girl?
No, sir, I'm a girl.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay, no, sir, it's fine.
Yeah, go ahead. Now I can better hear you. Tell me.
Yes, sir, that was all. I was saying that it was really nice that knowing that I could still change my stream in future. It still gave me hope that if I'm not able to keep up with it.
Anything which you love, just do that. Follow your passion.
Yes.
You might pick up design later on. You never know. keep that option open, you know. Do whatever you think it gives you pleasure.
Yes, sir. There are things that I like, but when someone's there, someone like forces me to do something, that then it kind of gets
don't do it. My son wanted to be a chef when he was four. When he was 4 years old, he wanted to be a chef. He never changed it. He's a chef entrepreneur now. And he's highly successful. He never changed anything. Yeah? So.
And I think, Neha, it's very important to also take your own time. Everybody is different. Everybody is absolutely a different individual to others, you know. You have your own, individuality. You have your own identity. And I think what you like the most, you will be able to, you know, bring the best in it. Not necessarily what the others are enjoying the most is the best. So I like something else, it's best for me. And likewise, it's going to be the best for you. So take your time, explore as much as you want.
And if you think you were forced to take a wrong decision and you cannot help it, just go ahead with it, you know, because it's possible that while some decision was wrong, later on you can always change it, you know, get out of that thing and then do something else. A lot of designers don't follow design. They don't design. They do something else. Yeah.
Yes.
A lot of engineers, the data shows that almost 1% engineers work as engineers. Only 1% engineers work as engineers. Rest of all are doing something else altogether. They would hardly use any of the things which they've learned in their 4 to 5 years of engineering learning. Nothing. But they must have learned something else beyond engineering that could be useful. Yeah.
Yes.
Like, for example, I've studied in IIT Bombay, which is one of the finest engineering colleges of India and globally also. But I still think that IIT Bombay can improve. Yeah. The engineering education is not the best.
Yes.
There have been some fantastic engineering colleges abroad, which are far, far, far better as learning institutions for engineering. For engineering, I'm talking about. Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
So, anybody else with any other question, or like I said, anything that really, you know, in this entire session?
It need not be about design also. It could be about anything else. Except that I'm not the any aunt. You don't ask me your personal questions. No.
Sir?
Don't ask me your personal question, that's all.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Jinesha Samdadia. Jinesha, you have a question? Yes.
No, sir, I don't have a question, but I want to tell something.
Please first show up.
I really like your beard.
can you show yourself?
Hi, sir.
Thank you so much. Someone like my beard.
No, it's really nice.
That it's so nicely designed and well kept.
Maintained. Okay. Not everyone can maintain their beard.
Yeah, I don't have small children to pull my beard, no? So it's well maintained. My children all grown up, you know. So.
Yeah, that's why I think.
Okay. Thank you so much. You have any questions? You might as well ask any question now.
No, I don't really have questions.
What did you like about the session? What did you learn? Except the beard. I'm sorry.
I really like, just like Neha, that it's okay to change streams. It's very difficult that you choose one stream and just stick to it. And now you have said that you can change stream. It's okay to change, and it's nothing wrong about it.
Yeah. Because all
this is what I took from the session.
Thank you so much. Because there are very blurred boundaries between all the fields of learning. So there are a lot of guys who did engineering and after that they did medicine. There are guys like that also. Just imagine engineering and medicine. There are a lot of guys I know who just went into engineering and then later on they moved to medicine and they were working as engineers in medical field. You know? because the boundary is going to be blurred in the future. There'll be a lot of movement, like a shifting clock, you know, like a shifting clock all the time. Art, design, science, technology will keep on moving into each other. And you must see that episode of Mary Oxman. You'll be absolutely floored. Yeah, what she has done. Check up that Netflix series called Abstract, and especially Neri Oxman's episode.
Yeah,
it's mind-boggling. See today, if possible.
Yeah.
She is one of the top 10 design thinkers in the world at present, you know. And she is also Brad Pitt's fiance. No, have you heard of Brad Pitt? You know heard of Brad Pitt? Brad Pitt is a Hollywood actor.
I'm sure everybody would have.
He was married to Angelina Jolie. But now I think they are divorced, and then he is dating Neri Oxman. You saw her, right? But you see her work. Absolutely fantastic work. The way she works, you know. I mean, you see the episode in which she makes a cocoon by employing 65,000 silk cocoons and none of them die. And they make a cocoon structure without dying. Look at that work. Yeah? Look at that work.
Yes, sir. Definitely look at that.
Yeah. Any questions? Any more questions?
Any other questions or any other thing that the students have to say?
Mohika Bansal, do you have a question? Mohika, can I see you?
No, sir, I do not.
Did you like the presentation?
Yes, sir, it was really great.
Did you understand it?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. And
in fact, sir, I myself am switching my PhD.
What is that? Yeah,
so I'm saying that I myself am switching fields. I'm currently doing engineering right now, and I'm switching to designing.
Thank you so much. And one more thing, can I ask you a question? You guys, you know, it's a very tough question.
Sure.
Very, very tough.
Yes.
Can I ask?
And someone has to respond. You know, one of you have to respond to it. Can I ask you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, absolutely.
Good. What makes you not put your camera on?
Now, this one is a difficult question, I'm sure.
It's a very difficult question because I always put my camera on so the people can see my beard. So you should always show up. Show up. Why don't you want to show up? Yeah. You, all of us are beautiful in whatever we are in, you know. Just appreciate the fact that you are, love yourself, you know. If you love yourself, you always put your camera on to show people. I love to show myself and to interact, you know. So there is a question I have. Now, who's going to respond to it? And in the process, at least one camera was on. Priyanka Chokse has put her camera on, which is good. So I want to ask you this question. Who's going to respond to it?
I think
it's a difficult question because this is a question I've asked my students also. My students.
Sir, I think it was a part of your unlearned categories. It was the FOMO, the fear of missing out, because of which people feel pressurized, you know.
What is
those boundaries that make you, like, I had my camera on because I don't have any.
Yeah, I know, but fear of missing out means what? You're missing out on showing yourself, you know.
We could take it that way. In fact, that's the way we should take it.
It's
right.
Fear of missing out. You know, I love this fact that students have started coming to the university. I'm very happy that they have come back to the university. It's so much of a great pleasure to, you know, look at them and talk to them and interact with them, you know. Vis-a-vis this whole digital platform, which has to start hating because I have to always see alphabets, you know. You are not alphabets. You guys are not alphabets. You're not A, E, I owe you.
The problem is
Garud or Deep Rajesh, you are someone. You have a face, you have a personality, and you have your own persona. Show it up.
Sir, I think that we don't switch on our camera because the last almost one year, 8 months, we've been in our own, we've developed that feeling of our comfort zone. So we don't want to get out of it. That's the reason why some people, including, don't switch on us.
Get out of this comfort zone. Yeah. There is something we should unlearn now. Unlearn this. Yeah, that would be the biggest unlearning exercise which will show up, you know. Because it makes so much of sense to put yourself on the screen so people can talk to you.
I think everyone has become introverts.
It's not an introvert. You know?
Some habits, like as you said, we have to now unlearn.
But I still don't have a satisfactory answer of this question. Why people put their cameras off? I think I will ask my students now. If you guys don't respond, I'm going to ask my students.
So I think students, I agree with your point of, you feeling little introvert, or maybe you think you're shabbily dressed, or you're in your pajamas.
Shabby? What is shabby? You want me to?
Yeah, I know. So I'm coming to that. So children, I think, eventually you'll have to come out of it. You can't be this.
You just have to show your mug shot.
Yes.
You're not showing your whole... I don't know what you're wearing underneath. There is, doesn't matter. You know, as long as you're able to put your face and you're on a bed or you're, wherever.
Yeah,
just show up. Show up. Yeah, just show up. Yeah. I just love to see people because we are anyway quite digitally flummoxed in terms of, watching screen. You might as well see faces and, look at people, make an eye contact,
Yeah.
Because there's so much we are missing out on not meeting people anyway. And then again, you don't meet them on digital space also.
Mm. Yes.
I mean, I had last few weeks or last few months, I had talked to each of my students. For every week, I talked to one of my students whom I've taught. And they just love to connect up with their videos on. We have a chat for hours. And there's so much I can learn just through their facial expression, through the way they talk, their tone of the voice, their eye contact. There's so much to learn from each other through just eye contact. It's important.
Absolutely.
Just imagine if you're doing a design research and your customer doesn't look at you. How will you make a research, Who's this? There's some noise.
Yeah, I think there was some noise issue.
Any question?
So I think I have Amit sir who has raised his hand.
Yes, Amit.
Yeah. I just wanted to reinforce what Sanjay has said on FOMO basically, because this is the question which is coming again and again. Now, fear of missing out, and Sanjay answered it so fabulously. If you are missing out something, maybe you are gaining something.
Yes.
And this is exactly what I have learned a few days back, a new term which is known as JOMO. So while you have FOMO, you have a JOMO also, and JOMO, joy of missing out. So I just thought to add this onto the discussion. Thank you,
Amit. So good. Because I was reading an article about this one guy who just switched off his Facebook and his WhatsApp account. He just switched it off for one week to start with, And suddenly he discovered pleasure in small things which he was doing, and he was not getting time to do that, He was just flowing with what people were telling him, and he was not able to live his own life. And you're living a life of avatar, by just going to the Facebook and just following that. And you never think that there's something else which you can do in that time, just figure out, I do this exercise with my students called, miss out on one thing. And we choose one thing every week. Like, for example, 1 week, I will not look at the mirror. I will not look at the mirror at all. Or I will not use my watch. And I will not use my mobile or whatever. And that improves your way of exploring yourself. For example, if you are not looking in a mirror, you will miss out in the beginning. You know, how do I look? But after that, you start live with this whole process of not looking at yourself, because you know that you look beautiful anyway. Yeah. Or not looking at your watch, and you develop a different sense of time. You figure out a different way of looking at the time. You know, you don't even ask anyone. You'll figure out, oh, what time it could be. You just guess, you know, and then it doesn't matter. You know, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, yeah, I think when you close one, option, like you said,
other windows open.
Yes, eventually.
That's why people who are blind, they have a very high sense of touch and high sense of smell and sound, because their one sense is cut off. So they are able to focus on other senses, you know. Yeah, that's how they improve their sense of touch. You, as a non-blind person or the, you know, a normal person, cannot read Braille so effectively as much as they can read, you know, because they are able to focus on that sense, you know. So try shutting off few things, you know, and then maybe things will improve.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Yeah. Because I think that's how you as designers even have to evolve. Like, you're talking about the process of growing. So this is how you grow. And like, when there was a girl who asked this question, how do I get ideas? So imagine when you're not allowed, or when you choose not to see watch, you'll have to have ideas to understand time.
Yeah.
So that's how you are really.
You'll start developing your own clock.
Yes.
You know, okay, it could be this time maybe, you know, and then you'll be aware of how the time is passing, and you know, it will be a new way to explore yourself. So shut off one thing, stop using one thing, and see how it improves your connectivity with yourself. You know, try that. I mean, she was asking me a couple of things they can try afresh. Try these things, you know. Yeah. First, start asking questions. There is one thing which Dia asked, you know, maintain a diary, a journal where you keep on writing questions. Ask any question. It doesn't matter what question. You know, it could be unpleasant question also, with no one knows the answer, but at least ask yourself. You know, that's important, because once you ask question, then you will figure out how to look for an answer, and then in that process you will be able to search and research and learn more. So move from information to exformation, known to unknown. But that is where design lies. Yeah. All the time. And that is what will drive you to learn more. Because if you learn everything, if someone tells you, okay, I'm talking about this, you say, I know it. That is the end. That's it. This is the end of your journey. I know it. Say, I don't know. Like, a lot of many times when I'm talking to my students, a lot of things which I don't know, they ask you. They said, okay, I don't know, but we can explore. I'll figure out. So there's no harm in accepting that you don't know something, you know, and you like to learn.
Yeah. Because that's when you start to explore those options. That's when you begin to think on those lines. Otherwise, when you know, you close yourself. So like, sir, during the session, you gave example of glass. You already have a very strong understanding of the word. So yeah. When you have to really, you know, break that typical meaning of glass and, you know, have something different to it, you really, really have to rack your brains. So this is exactly,
that is where the new design ideas will come. You know?
Yes.
When you say, look, I, like, it's very simple, redesign a glass. The moment it is, the exercise is given to you, you start asking questions. Like, glass, what does it mean? What do you mean by glass? You know, so now you're getting into unknown. Yeah, and that is where you start looking at new ways of looking at glass, you know? Because everything is being designed. Everything is there. Still, we are learning to design all the time, no? Because you're not designing anything. You are thinking. You are learning to think. That is important, you know? It's not that the people are interested in knowing how a new glass will look like, but they want to know. They want you to learn how to think about it. That is important. Yeah,
absolutely.
And look at nature. Nature will inspire you, because nature, it seems, has solved all of its problems. It is there for almost like 3.4 billion years. which is a huge time, and human beings have been there for a few million years, you know. So nature has resolved all these problems, you know, in all its glory. Look at it, how nature solves the problem. You know. Whenever you are getting stuck, look at nature. There is a very interesting site called asknature.org. asknature.org. Go to the website and ask a question there. Like how nature perceives color. Just ask question. There is a radio button there. Ask question. And you will be absolutely in a great journey how nature does it. asknature.org. And I teach this course. Nature-inspired design is my favorite subject which I teach. I have also taught to IIT Gandhinagar students just few months back. You know, nature-inspired design. I've taught to engineers and management guys and PhDs on nature-inspired design. I take this course. I've taken this course in MIT also. When I was the director of MIT Institute of Design. Okay. Any more questions? There's still time.
Yes, there is time. You can still ask questions if you want to, or you can share whatever you liked.
Yeah.
Or anything else.
Your comment, your feedback, you know, beyond my beard.
Maybe now your glasses, your spectacles, somebody might just end up saying that. So anything that's on your mind, students, you can absolutely go ahead and share. This is not just a lecture, but a discussion.
I'm also waiting for someone to tell me you're wearing a good turtleneck. You guys don't see that.
They didn't.
They saw, of course.
But I think they were more focused on the
Hello, sir.
Yes, boss.
I have one question.
Yes, you first show yourself. You first show, then only I'll ask you. I'll
respond. Hi, sir.
Yes, Parth Shinde. First of all, why did you put your camera off?
Sir. Sir, my question is, like, at what point our product is copied instead of inspired?
What does it mean?
Like, every time I'm designing something, like I'm trying to design, so I have heard that never saw reference image or never see other products on same topics. Like, our focus is changed on that. Like, we have to do like that and like this. So we are never open-minded on what we are going to do. So at what point our product become copied instead of inspired?
See, there is a word called create. Yeah, there's a word called create. Yeah, designers don't create anything. Nature creates. Yeah, we don't create anything. We design. Now, design is a conscious effort. Yeah, so it can have inputs from anywhere. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You can cross-reference, you can check anything, figure out yourself, you know. But you, if you are copying it exactly the way the other part is, you're not learning enough. You're not learning only. What are you learning then? You're just learning to copy it. You have not done anything to it. What is your contribution to it? So you can use references, you can use inspiration from products, you know, but think yourself as well. What is it which you want to do? What part you want to change? How you want to change the experience, the human experience? That will require a deep dive into the whole process of designing. Yeah? Are you getting it?
Parth, are you satisfied?
Don't worry. So don't worry about cross-referencing. You can see as many products as you want, but be truthful to yourself. What is your contribution? What is your idea? The idea can be a very small idea. But if it's your idea based on your research and your observation and your insights, it's fine. It's fine. Absolutely fine. So don't worry about it. Be truthful to yourself, yeah? You know it, not what you're doing. Isn't it? Yeah. So you can get inspired from anywhere. Nature, people get inspired from nature. Some people are copying nature, but because they don't copy the context in which nature has made it, it doesn't work. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
So if you're designing a product which looks like a leaf and it doesn't have anything to do with what leaf does, then it is a it is of no use, no? So you can't design a mobile looking like a leaf, because that is, there's ornamental design. There is just a superficial design, you know. You're not learning anything from the leaf at all. You're just looking at the contour and the form, which is not, nature doesn't work with form. Nature, for nature, there's nothing called form. Form and function is the one for nature. It's one thing. So don't change the form just because you are inspired by a leaf of a mobile. A mobile has different purpose, a different functionality. You know, so just stick to that.
Thank you.
Because a leaf-like mobile would not work. But if you're making a something else which uses why the leaf is created, you know, then it will be interesting. So there's one student of mine who has designed a leaf which is like a street light and which captures the sun rays and absorb energy and glows in the night. So he used the leaf as a concept and not just the shape, but as a concept. Because a leaf works like that, is a design factory, right? It converts solar energy into food, yeah, using chlorophyll. So that was a beautiful idea which he used, you know. So understand that. Does it answer your question?
Yes, sir. Thanks.
Thank you.
Aditi, do you want to ask any question?
Go ahead.
Aditi, do you want to ask any question? Aditi Godha.
And Priyanka, did you ask a question? Priyanka, are you Priyanka?
Yes, sir, I'm Priyanka.
Hi, Priyanka.
Hi, sir. Sir, I did not ask any question, but I have one question in my mind.
Very good.
That is related to exam that you are going to give.
Yes.
So, sir, I am from a commerce background. I did BCom. Mm-hmm. And then I decided to switch my field from commerce to designing. So, yes. I see the last year graph that majorly IITs take engineers and other. So, is there any?
What is that? IITs take engineers? I don't understand. What is it?
There is some eligibility thing that bachelor's in engineering or BDes or BTech or BArch. But it wasn't written that they will take commerce students or something like that.
For what? I mean, for where you want to go? I'm not able to understand.
Sir, I want to do MDes in interaction design.
Go ahead and do it.
So, I'm aiming for other colleges, but I also want to give seed. So, I'm eligible for seed. That is the minimum criteria for seed is 3 years graduation in any field. But yes. After that, yes. But yes. The colleges have its own criteria also. Yes.
What about IDC, Bombay?
Sir, I checked there also. So, they are also taking BArch, BDes, and BTech, I guess.
So, check it. Go somewhere else.
Yes, sir. That only I decided that I have to do this anyhow.
Come to Avantika.
Because Avantika is very close to my house, sir. I'm from Bhopal and Ujjain is very close.
Just walk.
Excellent. Excellent in that.
So don't worry about, and please don't worry about if IDC doesn't take it. They may have their own reasons for it. So don't worry about it, you know. Yeah, go to places, because for me, it doesn't make a difference whether you're from commerce background, because you have to anyway unlearn and relearn and learn so many things, you know.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so as long as you have been learning in your commerce background, it is good enough, you know. Then you can start learning again. It doesn't matter. I had one student in MIT, my first batch of MDes. That guy was a B-commerce, you know. At present, he's one of the finest transportation designer in India. He has won even global award and he was sponsored by Mercedes-Benz to visit Germany for his internship. He was a commerce student.
Yes, sir.
And he was one of the finest transportation designer at present in India. Young guy. Yeah? So don't worry.
Yeah. I think till the time you're able to follow your passion and work towards it, I don't think anything will stop it. I'm sure you'll always find a way.
Just keep learning, because you have to, even when you're learning design, when you work in industry, you have to relearn it.
Yes.
Yeah. Everywhere there is relearning happening, you know.
Absolutely.
For example, I'm just telling you, an engineering guy going and learning medicine. It's a lot of relearning for him, no? Mm. But there are people who go for it because they follow their passion. They think that engineering is not good enough. Let me figure out if I can learn, if I can use medicine, engineering back, learning in medicine, you know, to design products. You know. There will be also, engineers will be required to design organs in the future, human organs. It's possible that you might be designing human organs, you know, artificial heart, artificial lungs. And for that, you might require a background in engineering and medicine both. So what about that? For example, in commerce, you know how to run a business, you know accountancy. So you don't have to learn the financial part of a startup, you know. Mm-hmm. If you want to go in industry, you will understand what is their budget sheet, the cost sheet, you know, you will understand the financial part. So you already have some knowledge which you can use.
Yes, sir. That's why I also opted for information design in NID. For NID, so that infographics and charts and statistics is used there. So I can offer that. My commerce background will be useful in that.
Don't really get constrained by your commerce background itself. You can learn new things also. Yeah, don't look for something which is like on par with what you've learned. You know? It's not necessarily. You can do something else. Don't try to see the link because of what you have done in your graduation. Look for what you want to do.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if you want to become a something else, you go for something else. Don't look for this kind of a parity. There is no parity. Yeah.
You don't have to keep connecting the dots.
Don't connect dots now. Connect dots later.
Yeah. Absolutely.
It's too early to connect dots, you know, because you never know why you came for commerce. You never know, right? Why you opted for commerce, you don't know. I mean, or you may know. I don't know.
Sir, I think I followed the mob mentality.
You should have taken decision that time, you know, that you want to do something else, you know. You want to do something else. Decide that time, you know. So now this is another occasion for you to decide something else, you know.
Yes, sir.
Now you don't get forced by what people say and what the normal information tells you. Yeah. So there's no relation between information graphics and commerce, by the way. There's no relation. So don't go by this chart and there's no relation. It's a new area altogether.
Okay.
Yeah. So don't relate like that. Do what you want to do. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
What do you want to do? You want to, have you
sir,
figured
I out? Want, yes, yes. I want to do graphic designing.
Do that. Just do that. Yeah,
so we can choose two disciplines in NID. So I choose first as graphic and second as information.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All the best.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Anybody, any other question? Anything else that you have on your mind that you want to ask?
Because I'm happy that we have spent 45 minutes asking questions, you know.
Absolutely.
We had to really work very hard. Purnima and me had to really work very hard for that.
Absolutely. He's very difficult to ask.
There's still a lot of guys who are sleeping. And there are a lot of guys who have, I think, disappeared for dinner.
Yes, yes. Most of them.
Yeah, because they think there is a better option. Let them ask some question to their moms, you know. Aaj kya banaya hai? Khane mein kya hai?
How have you decorated the dinner table, maybe?
Yeah, khane mein kya hai?
Absolutely, absolutely. So students, just this is the last 10 minutes. So I will just, say, first of all, thank you so much for staying with us, for listening to sir and attending this session. I hope this was a meaningful session and it really gave you one additional angle or point to your current knowledge. And second of all, if you must not know, just to again tell you, sir is Professor Emeritus with Avantika University, which is in Ujjain. And Avantika University is India's first design-centered university promoted by MIT Group of Institutions, Pune, and has a proven legacy of 40 years in the field of higher education. This university is established by the government of Madhya Pradesh because it's in Madhya Pradesh. And this, so the basic core of this university is project-based education framework, which is developed by a team of passionate and proven professionals like Professor Sanjay Dande, former director of IIT Kanpur, Professor Kirti Trivedi, an alumnus of RCA London. And this academic programs that are present in Avantika are led by DICE, which is Design, Innovation, Creativity and Enterprise, with interdisciplinary curriculum and experiential learning at the core. So the unique model on which this academic structure is based on is integrated transdisciplinary approach that harmoniously blends design thinking and creative spirit. So I won't keep on talking about this. All I want to tell you students that this university is developed, you know, after the experience of 40 years, which is huge. And this university gives you that freedom of thinking, learning, giving you that space to understand, explore, because we believe, like sir said, we believe in this process of developing students' mind. And we can't really have a process of developing the minds. It is about, you know, by your own experience. We do not give you that, we give you that freedom. We do not put you under any restrictions of, you know, choosing and of selecting, of, you know, understanding. This university gives you that freedom to explore. Yeah. So I would just say understand or check our website and read about us more. Avantika University. And if you have any other questions or if you have anything that you want to ask that you couldn't ask today, or probably after the session you realize there was something more I could have asked sir, and probably there was a query which you wanted to get back to us, please connect with your people and we will share Sanjay sir's number, and or me, Purnima, you can connect to any of us and we'll be able to solve your answers and your queries. Okay.
So is the time for dinner now?
Yes. Is there anything else that you want to ask? Anybody from the BRDS team wants to say something?
A faculty or someone? Faculty, is there? Is there any faculty from BRDS?
I think we have somebody. Yes, Tushar. Tushar from BRDS.
Where is Tushar? Hello, Tushar. Where are you? Where is Tushar? Are you there?
I think he's not available right now.
Okay. Right on. So if there are no more questions, let's break for dinner.
Yeah, Purnima. Hi, Purnima. Are you, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. You are.
Yeah, I think you just elaborate on the placements also. Now, since MIT and Avantika, we have a pool drive. So I think it would be insightful for the students to know about the placements also.
So I think we have 51 companies who visited us, and we have had an excellent placement drive. I mean, irrespective of the COVID situation that we had and the lockdown situation that we had, and it was very difficult, you know, to connect to industries and to really have, you know, people together, but still our placements were excellent. All our students have been placed, and the highest package that we got is 15 lakhs for BDES. So, and our average package is 8 lakhs. So I would say that students, though I personally believe that we have some students who did not want to sit in the placement drive because they had their own creations, they had their own projects, which they wanted to drive and be the entrepreneurs. So that could also be one of the options that you choose for. But irrespective of that, the university has excellent placement options available. So please visit our websites and you'll be able to get all the answers.
Okay. Anything else?
No, I don't think so, sir.
Okay. So thank you.
Can you tell about admission processes?
So for the admission process, you'll have to fill up the form. You'll have to visit our website. And Avantika is conducting its own test, which is called ADST. That is happening in 3 rounds. You can visit our website, fill our form, appear for ADST. At the same time, you can also fill in for DAT, which is Design Aptitude Test, and sit for that exam, which will happen in the month of April. And then, of course, you will have to appear for the studio test and simultaneously for the interview. And you will be selected accordingly. If you clear these rounds, you'll be selected for the university. You'll be given the offer letter. Is there any other question that you want to ask?
No, ma'am. Thanks.
All right.
This sonata is something which I hate, you know.
I think the students are a little more tired now.
So, I am not tired.
I'm sure, sir. I'm sure. So students, see, this is so bad for you guys. This is not good. You guys can't just give us this kind of a sonata.
So at least say bye.
Say bye. We'll be happy.
Bye.
Thank you, sir. The session was really informative. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
And you can always engage in some discussion with me. I think Poornima can share my mail address.
Yes, I will.
And you can send mail.
Yes, we will.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
Bye, Poornima. Can I just log off?
Yes, absolutely. I'm ending the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.